I had both of my big birds out, so I thought I'd go ahead and make a video describing the difference between the Tyco talking big bird and the Ideal talking big bird. Here I have both versions, the Ideal on the right and the Tyco on the left. And as you can see, the Ideal big bird is much larger. Even his feet are bigger, and his hands are too, I think. No, his hands are the same, but overall, he's a lot bigger. Another thing, looking at him from the front, the Ideal big bird tilts his head to the left a lot, while on the Tyco big bird, the head tilt is only slight. And this guy, he's got a lopsided face anyway. So yeah, that's basically it looking at him from the front. Now when you turn them around, you'll really see the big difference between these two. I'm going to lift up their tails so you can see. The Ideal big bird has what I call an internal cassette player, basically like what you'd find in a car. You stick the cassette tape in there. What turns them on and off is a mechanism inside the cassette player. Basically, when you put the cassette in, he comes on automatically, and you push the eject button to turn him off. And he's got a little volume control right there. Another thing is he has a satellite jack right there, and that's where you plug in Cookie Monster and Oscar. And finally, if you can get the battery door open, which mine is pretty stuck, you'll have to trust me on this one. He takes 4 AA batteries. And on the Tyco big bird, you can see it's vastly different. He has a external cassette player, like what you find on Teddy Ruxpin. Open up the battery compartment, he takes C batteries, which I don't understand why it only takes AA batteries to operate such a larger toy, but who knows. Yeah, he's got the little front cassette player right there. It's marked Tyco. Let's see. The year is listed as 1990, and on the Ideal Big Bird, it's 1986. You've got the same volume control right here, and to turn them on, you put the cassette tape in and press play. Now, interestingly enough, both of these toys work off of the same cassettes. Let's see, right here I've got I Want to Go Home, one of my favorite tapes when I was little. So I'm going to put this in the Ideal Big Bird first, and then the Tyco one, so you can see the difference in playback. So stick the...
Really something. Before I tell you about it, though, I want to tell you about this little sound.
Uh-oh, sometimes this volume doesn't work.
Remember, start on the first page of the book. The page that has the picture of my friends waving goodbye to me. And whenever you hear this, turn the page. Okay, here we go. Today was going to be a big day for me. I was going to visit Granny Bird.
So that's what playback sounds like for the Ideal Big Bird. Now, if he'll sit up straight, I'll put the same cassette in the Tyco Big Bird. One thing you'll notice, one thing that I've noticed for all of these guys, is the sound is unusually deeper. It's not a slower playback, it's something with the speaker that they used.
My friends took me to the bus stop. Goodbye, Big Bird. Have fun.
Also, he's a lot louder.
They said, I will miss you too, I said. Did you remember that that sound means turn the page? would never get there. It's been over hills, under bridges.
Yeah, he's much louder at the same, oh dear. There we go. He's much louder at the same volume setting as the Tyco Big Bird. Also, if you notice, his eyelids have 3 degrees of movement. One right here, two right there, and then three. The Ideal Big Bird, his eyes only go from up to down and back. So, yeah, that's it for the differences between the... Whoa! Sit up, buddy. For the Tyco and Ideal Big Birds. Oh! One thing before I forget. His eyelids, you cannot move them once they're in the down position. You can open and close... Oh! There we go. I don't know what that just did, but somehow the mouth and eyelids are connected. Learn something new every day. So, yeah, that's pretty much it. If you ever see one of these guys for sale and you're not sure which version it is, look first at the head tilt, and then if that's still... then give you a clue as to which version it is, look at the cassette player. The Ideal Big Bird is much harder to find and much more expensive. He's also better quality than the Tyco one. And the Tyco one is, of course, much more common, much cheaper, and breaks a lot easier. Anything else I've forgotten? Oh. One thing I found out, just for fun, the Ideal Big Bird is very squishy. He's got lots of foam in his stomach. The Tyco Big Bird, no, he doesn't have hardly any foam at all. He's also a lot less fluffy. The Ideal Big Bird's got lots and lots of fur. This guy doesn't have very much at all. But, yeah, they're pretty similar, and at the same time, they're pretty different. So, I hope this helps anyone who was, not sure, which version they had, or was looking to buy one and wasn't sure which one it was. So, yeah, if you have any questions, leave a comment or send me a message. Thanks.